Hello, I am Pramod Kumar. Today we will study English of class 12, CBSE. Our book is Flamingo and our poem is Aunt Jennifer's Tigers, written by Adrienne Rich. Before we start, I will request you to jot down my website address. You can visit the website and find lot of reading material for yourselves. Your chapters well explained, meaning of hard words, and questions and answers, whatever I have been able to give. After a few moments, we will rub it off. We go ahead. This poet, Adrienne Rich, she was from the USA, and she is widely known for her involvement in women's movement. And all through her works, a strong resistance to racism and militarism echoes. It goes through all her works. This poem addresses the constraints of married life a woman experiences. This poem addresses the constraints of married life a woman experiences. The poet was born in 1929, so maybe she would have written it around 1950-55, around 70 years ago. Poet illustrates her feminist concern. What are the feminist concerns? Mainly, concerns of gender inequality, inequality between male and female, male dominance, male chauvinism, predominantly patriarchal society, women being relegated to the second status. These are her concerns. In the world dominated by male, a woman of her time was supposed to be a dutiful housewife. In the world dominated by male, during her time, means 1945-50, 55-60, a woman of her time was supposed to be a dutiful and housewife. She need to perform the duties and she need to take care of the house. This poem, through the world of Aunt Jennifer, the poet has expressed her opinions through the image of Aunt Jennifer, right? So this poem, through the world of Aunt Jennifer, tells us about her inner desire to free herself from the shackles of a heavy marriage. Heavy marriage means? Heavy marriage means a difficult, painful, difficult, painful marriage, right? Heavy marriage. This poem, through the world of Aunt Jennifer, tells us about her inner desire to free herself from the shackles, chains of a heavy marriage, and also from a patriarchal society. The society is dominated by male, right? Her wish to live a free, fearless life is indicated by her choice of design. In this poem, Aunt Jennifer Tigers. So what she has done, Aunt has done, the character of this poem, she has expressed her wish to live a free, fearless life by portraying tigers. Tigers are considered as free and fearless, right? Now we start the poem. Aunt Jennifer Tigers prance across a screen. So what do we mean by this? Aunt Jennifer She is doing some embroidery, some weaving. She is weaving the image of tigers on a screen. What is a screen? What is a screen? The glass surface of a TV or a computer can be called a screen. So, she is knitting, embroidering the image of tigers on the screen. And Jennifer's tigers prance across the screen. Prance means? Prance. It means to move about with quick and high steps. Tigers are prancing in the image. Means tigers are moving about in a quick and with high steps, raised steps, right? Bright topaz denizens, the poet is writing about the tigers. Bright topaz denizens of a world of green. So, the tigers have been shown as bright topaz. What is topaz? It is a gem. Right? Bright, shiny gem. Bright topaz. Like bright topaz. Denizens means a person, animal or plant which lives and grows in a particular area. So, bright topaz denizens in a world of green. In a world of green means in a forest. Forest kind of a thing. In a world of green. They don't fear the man beneath the tree. Aunt Jennifer has drawn, embroidered, woven a tree also. But the tigers drawn, woven by Aunt Jennifer, don't fear the man beneath the tree. Why they don't fear? Because tigers are fearless, one, plus they are not real. Tigers are fearless and they are not real. They are embroidered on a screen. They don't fear the men beneath the tree. Pace means to move about in quick steps and to walk down the same area like this again and again, as if excited or nervous or angry. Suppose I am walking here like this quickly again and again in the same area, it could indicate that, what it could indicate? That I am in some angry or some excited state of mind. So the tigers in the embroidery, they pace in sleek chivalric certainty. Sleek means elegant, smooth and shiny. Sleek chivalric certainty. What is chivalric certainty? As if these tigers have all the qualities of a knight, knight. What are the qualities of a knight? Loyalty, courtesy and bravery. So the tigers are pacing up and down in sleek, elegant, smooth, shiny, sleek, chivalric certainty, as if they own all the qualities of a knight. and those qualities are loyalty, courtesy, bravery, right? Then we go to the second stanza. There Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her wool. She is doing something with wool and her fingers are fluttering. So, what is the meaning of flutter here? Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her wool. Flutter means move something lightly and quickly as if the person was in a confused or nervous state of mind. Suppose I am knitting something with wool and my fingers are fluttering. It means that I am undergoing some anxiety, right? Or I am nervous or I am confused. Fingers are fluttering. They are not stable, right? Find even the ivory needle hard to pull. Aunt Jennifer finds even the ivory needle. What is the meaning of ivory needle here? Ivory needle has two qualities. It's very smooth and it's very light. So, though the ivory needle with which she is working on the wool is very smooth and light, her fingers are fluttering. It means she is in a confused, nervous, agitated, excited mind. Ivory needle also indicates male dominance. How does it indicate male dominance? Forgetting the elephant tusk. See, how do we get ivory needle? We need elephant tusk. And forgetting that tusk, people would have killed elephants. So here also male dominance is indicated, right? The massive weight of uncle's wedding band. The massive weight. Why the poet has used massive weight? Uncle's wedding band is there on the fingers of Aunt Jennifer. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band. Massive weight. Why? The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. Massive weight because of unhappy, difficult, painful marriage. Aunt Jennifer had unhappy, difficult, painful marriage. That is why the poet writes, the massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. Now, in the next stanza, we come across, in the next stanza, the poet writes, when aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ringed with ordeals she was mastered by. Even when she is dead, even when Aunt Jennifer is dead, her terrified hands, why her hands were terrified? Because of the fear of the husband. Her terrified hands will lie still. Why hands will lie still? Because she is dead. Hands will lie still. But even then, the hands will be ringed. The hands will be ringed with what? Ringed with ordeals. What are the ordeals? Difficulties, trauma, pain that she faced in her marital life. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still. Ringed with ordeals, she was mastered by. Why the poet has used the word mastered by? See, it was a predominantly patriarchal society, male dominated, and woman was supposed to be a beautiful housewife. So, as if the lady or the wife was treated like an animal or a slave. Animals and or slaves are mastered by human beings, right? So as if she was mastered. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ringed with ordeals. Even after her death, her hands will lie still. Even now, ringed with ordeals. Ring is there. Ring with, even if that ring is not there, the ordeals are there, which she has suffered the whole life. She was mastered by, those ordeals relate to mastery by the husband. Patriarchal society, male dominated, and a woman being expected, supposed to be a dutiful housewife, right? The tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid. Even after her death, Aunt Jennifer's death, the tigers that she has drawn on the panel, will continue. What they will continue? To go on prancing. Prancing means to move about with quick raised steps, high steps. Even when she is dead, the tigers will keep on prancing around in a proud and unafraid way. Tigers are proud because they are free. They are fearless. Those who are afraid and not free cannot feel pride. So the tigers, even after Aunt Jennifer's death, will keep on prancing, proud and unafraid. They are proud and unafraid. So what has happened? The poet has brought in the image of tigers. Why? Because Aunt Jennifer wants to be free and fearless. So in order to express her wish to be free and fearless, she has drawn the image of tigers on the screen. She has conveyed her mind. She has conveyed her wish. Whether it is fulfilled or not is a different matter. But she has expressed her wish that she wants to be free and fearless by drawing those tigers on the panel. Tigers which are considered as proud, free, fearless. They are not afraid. They don't fear anybody. Right? So this poem, what is this poem? Addresses the constraints of married life a woman experiences. The poet had illustrated her feminist concerns, and at that time, the poet was born in 1929, we can presume that it was around 1950, around 70 years ago. That time, in the world dominated by male, A woman of the poet's time was supposed to be a dutiful wife, right? And this poem talks of a heavy, difficult, painful marriage of Aunt Jennifer. She was always afraid, scared of her husband. That is why she used to find, we find her fingers fluttering through the wool. Even when she is using an ivory needle, which is very soft, very smooth and very light, because her mind is terrified, afraid, she is not free, she is not fearless, right? I hope you found the poem easy to understand. For more, please visit my website where you can get more information. And in case of any query, please approach me on my email ID, which will be there on the thumbnail to the video. Thank you very much.